In lots of ways. And if we see here, this is saying the name of our big guest this week. Please welcome the man that really needs a little introduction, Mr. Johnny Cash.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps a-rolling on down the San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Fancy dining car, they're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming, I know I can't be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. riders loped on by him. He heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell, riding on our range, cowboy, change your ways. Today are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-yi. By frail and fragile bars, restless by day and by night, rants and rages at the stars. God help the beast in me. Oh, the beast in me has had to learn to live with pain, and how to shelter from the rain, and in the twinkling of an eye might have to be restrained. God help the beast in me. Sometimes it tries to kid me that it's just a teddy bear, and even somehow manages to vanish in the air, and that is when I must beware of the beast in me. That everybody knows, they've seen him out dressed in my clothes, patently unclear. If it's New York or New Year, God help the beast in me. The beast in me.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I was at Nick Lowe's house when he said he had a new song for me that Nick and Carlene had written. It took a long time to get it, but when I finally got it, I realized it was for me, all right. But the kind of theme of the album is sin and redemption, and thank God for redemption, or I wouldn't be here, and which is the title of the last song I wrote for the album. Sorry. From his hands it came down, from his side it came down, from his feet it came down and ran to the ground. Between heaven and hell a teardrop fell, in the deep crimson dew the tree of life grew. And the blood gave life to the branches of the tree, and the blood was the price
that set the captives free, and the numbers that came through the fire and the flood clung to the tree and were redeemed by the blood. From the tree streamed the light that started the fight. Round the tree grew a vine on whose fruit I could dine. My old friend Lucifer came, fought to keep me in chains, but I saw through the tricks of 666. And the blood gave life to the branches of the tree, and the blood was the price that set the captives free, and the numbers that came through the fire and the flood clung to the tree and were redeemed by the blood. From his hands it came down, from his side it came down, from his feet it came down and ran to the ground. Then a small inner voice said, you do have a choice. The vine engrafted me and I clung to the tree. And the blood gave life to the branches of the tree, and the blood was the price that set the captives free, and the numbers that came through the fire and the flood. I clung to the tree and was redeemed by the blood.
Thank you very much indeed, Carlene Anderson. We'll be hearing more from her in a minute. She's got a scorching voice, isn't she?
She's fabulous.
Is she almost the opposite of
so
yours?
So is the band, you know, the band great is great. Yeah.
It'd be fantastic. Maybe we even heard you do a number with Carlene singing it.
Hey, let's do it. I'd love to.
At the end of the show, we could.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, your new album is very acoustic that you've got out. We're very pleased to have you on. And on the sleeve notes, it said there's some things about how when you were a child and you'd hear panthers outside prowling around.
Yeah.
What was that about?
Well, when I was a boy and I was went to a friend's house to play, or he played the guitar, and I would sing along with him. Then it would be a long walk at night back home. Mm-hmm. And it was like a jungle out there in the Delta Land in Arkansas where I grew up. And I'd hear panthers at night.
Terrifying.
Panthers. And I would sing as loud as I could sing all the way home on that gravel road, mm-hmm. barefoot.
What songs would you sing?
Oh, whatever I was singing with my friend with the guitar. Mm-hmm. Old folk songs, you know, and gospel and spirituals.
Well, what were the first things that you heard when you were a child? What was
it? One of the first things I heard was a song. My mother played the guitar and sang a song called "What Would You Give in Exchange for Your Soul?" And then the first one I learned was called "Hobo Bill's Last Ride." And then I lived within hearing distance of the Memphis radio mm-hmm. stations when I was growing up, so I heard a lot of blues and black gospel and spirituals. Mm-hmm. Sister Rosetta Tharpe was one of my favorites.
I loved her. Up Above My Head, yeah.
Right, Up Above My Head. Didn't it rain, rain, rain? This Train's Bound for Glory.
Yeah.
I still sing those songs. Yeah.
No, I loved her. And now, when you first, I don't mean to sort of zoom through, in this short program that we've got, to zoom through your whole career, but you wrote your first songs in the Army.
Air Force.
The Air Force, sorry. And, and then did shows with Elvis Presley, and you were part of that whole Sun thing.
Yeah.
Was that very important to you now, looking back all that Sun days?
I guess so. We were just having a lot of fun at the time. Mm-hmm. There was Elvis and Carl Perkins and Jerry Lee Lewis and mm-hmm. myself. And we were very young and just having a good time, mm-hmm. just hoping it would last.
Yeah. Your first records were produced by Sam Phillips and mm-hmm. your new one by Rick Rubin, who first produced mm-hmm. the Beastie Boys. Do Sam and Rick have anything in common at all, do you think?
Yeah, and as producers, they both let me do what they realized I was feeling, mm-hmm. you know. Sometimes this album should have been called Painfully Honest, because that's what it is, just me and my guitar. And sometimes we would let a flat note
go or a sharp note or a bad note on the guitar because it felt right.
Yeah.
You know, the feeling was there. Yeah. That was the important thing, was the feeling. That was the way it was with Sam, mm-hmm. and that's the way it was with Rick Rubin. Mm-hmm. If it feels right, if you can stand to hear it, go for it, you know?
Yeah, great. Now, I believe we've got a little bit of archive footage of you.
Oh.
When you, because you had your own TV show in mm-hmm. Nashville, and you worked with Bob Dylan. I think we've got footage of you with Bob Dylan over here.
Yeah. Well, it's a restless, hungry feeling. It don't do nobody no good. And everything I'm saying, you can say it just as good. 'Cause you're right from your side, Bob, that I'm right from mine.
I know it.
We're just one too many mornings and 1,000 miles behind. They're right.
Down the street the dogs are barking, yeah. And the day is getting dark. As the night comes in a falling, those dogs will lose their bark. And the silent night will shatter from the sounds inside my mind. As I'm one too many mornings and 1,000 miles behind.
I know you had one or two arguments with the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville and things. How did they take to Bob Dylan when you?
Well, Bob performed on my show on stage of the Grand Ole Opry House, mm-hmm. the Ryman Auditorium, mm-hmm. along with people like Pop Staples and the Staple mm-hmm. family. Everybody that did my show, it was at the Grand Ole Opry House. Mm-hmm. But actually, I was on really good terms with the Grand Ole Opry by then. I'd gotten over some of the things I was doing, you know. And they had kind of forgiven me, so I was back in the good graces
yeah.
by then.
Yeah, yeah. You had your own TV show in Nashville. Was it anything mm-hmm. like this at all, the sort of...
Like that?
Yeah, like this show here.
Oh, like this one. Well, I just was noticing this. I mean, talking about this opening of this show, it was really great the way it opened, you know, and the great talent. Yeah, it was kind of a variety show like yeah. this, you know. People from all walks of musical life and a different way of programming, you know, the different setups. Mm-hmm. I like that.
Interesting you say you should have Pop Staples on, because that's who we've gone on now. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, Johnny Cash, and we'll look forward to hearing you on another show. Thank you. Johnny Cash. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, a huge ensemble of marvellous talent on the stage, ladies and gentlemen. I'll leave it at that.
I was standing by my window on one cold and cloudy day when I saw come rolling in for to carry my mother away.
behind her. I tried to hold up and be strong and brave.
Oh, yeah.
But I could not hide my sorrow.